Well, another new year is right around the corner, but are you any closer to living your dream? If you're like most people, the answer is probably not. Take a look.
Only 6% of people actually end up doing what they dreamed of as a child. The truth is, life doesn't always pan out the way we hope, and many of us are left wondering what we need to do next. Popular millennial pastor Chad Veach lives in Los Angeles, a place dubbed the City of Broken Dreams. He says we can correct our destructive thinking and move past disappointments in life. In his book, Faith Forward Future, Chad shares how we can reach for a better dream and points us towards the abundant plans God has for each of us.
Well, welcome, Chad Veach. Good to have you with us.
Thank you so much for having me on.
Book. And you talk so candidly about disappointments in life. I mean, everybody's got them. I don't think anybody's
exempt from facing disappointment.
But those stats that we just heard are so significant. I mean, why do you think so many people are so disappointed with their
lives?
Well,
I think a lot of times we're disappointed because we had expectations set. We thought life was going to turn out a certain way. We didn't plan for, the sickness. We didn't plan for the setback. People move to L.A. in particular, and they can envision what they want to happen. But I always think God has something better.
Yes.
And we have to learn how to move past disappointments. They're part of life. People could let us down. We could let ourselves down.
For sure.
But we've got to learn how to move on.
Yeah.
My dad used to say growing up, there's no need to cry over spilled milk.
Yeah.
It is what it is. It happened. We've got to move on from it. And so that's really what the book's about.
It's today, and we're heading toward tomorrow.
Yeah, that's it, right?
Well, what do you think it is that keeps so many of us from achieving our dreams? Because less than 6% actually accomplish what they dreamt of doing.
Well, I think a lot of times we hold on to our dream, and we've got to start to exchange it for God's dream.
Yeah.
I just think God's plan is so much better than our plan. You know, the Bible says, many plans does a man have in his own heart, but the Lord directs his steps. Translation, I've got something better than your best plan.
And trust me.
Yeah, and trust me. I always think, God's ultimate plan is his son. So you can't really know God's plan until you start following his son.
Yeah.
And then as you follow his son, the adventure of a lifetime unfolds. And I think that's where you start getting into that exceedingly and abundantly, far above anything you could ask, think, or imagine life. It's in Jesus.
At 21, you had big dreams.
Yeah.
And then things kind of took a different turn. What happened?
Yeah. Well, I had a significant breakup. And I really thought that I was going to, marry this person, and which is fine. But I felt God saying, this isn't the one. I've got something else. And it was a tug of war. It was a battle of the wills.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, I got to a spot where I go, it's clear. I get it. I surrender.
Yeah.
And I made the decision. I can't imagine life now without my wife, without my children. We're about to have our fourth.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
That's exciting. Super Bowl Sunday, he said, no less. Memorable. But talk a little bit about the painfulness of that, because even though you were listening and even though you heard the word of God, you still had to pick up the phone and go through the discomfort of the actual breakup.
And I actually didn't do it for a number of months. I actually was just willfully disobedient for a number of months. And it wasn't until I hit rock bottom.
Yeah.
That I really surrender. I think sometimes God narrows our options until he's our only option.
Yeah.
He did it with Jonah, not because he doesn't love Jonah or love us, but because he's so committed to the ultimate plan. He knows what's best, and he'll do everything he can to get us there.
There are some practical steps that we can take to help us do what you talked about earlier, move past disappointment, move past even failures.
Right.
Talk about some of those.
Yeah, well, I think one of the key things is we've got to start seeing ourselves the way that God sees us.
Yeah.
Shame is such a bully.
Oh.
Shame points his finger in our face and says, you are the mistake that you just made. But God says, you might have made a mistake, but you're not a mistake. Mm-hmm. We've got to start to hear what heaven has to say over our lives rather than what the enemy, who is the accuser of the brethren, who wants to accuse us and totally bully us with guilt and condemnation. So I think it starts with, if we're going to move on, we've got to see ourselves the way that God sees me forgiven.
Mm-hmm.
God sees me as I'm supposed to be.
Yeah.
God sees me as the righteousness of God. And if I'll start seeing myself that way, I'll start to move forward with faith.
Usually it's us rather than other people who see us inaccurately, inappropriately.
That's it.
Yeah.
I read a book years ago, What to Say When You Talk to Yourself.
Yeah.
Because I think so much of life is learning how to have self-talk and how to have a healthy self-view. And until you have that identity, you can't really move forward in your God-given potential.
Talk a little bit about finding purpose in pain. Mm. I mean, you've experienced that on a personal level.
Yeah.
How do we do that?
Yeah. Well, I think it's all life is a perspective. Life is not about what happens to you. Mm-hmm. Life is about how you respond to what happens to you.
Boy, that's
so I've just learned, you know, our daughter's story, my six, just turned six, has defied the doctors, has been just a miracle baby. But I'll tell you, from the moment we got the diagnosis, we decided we were going to let this girl be a symbol in our home of hope, belief, faith. We're going to just believe that God will use her story and use this circumstance for His good. Mm-hmm. And I think if we wouldn't have made that decision, I don't know if I'd be here today. Yeah. I don't know where my marriage would be. I don't know where my soul would be. I don't know where my daughter's life would be. But because we chose to trust God, we found purpose in our pain. I think God, He's the only God that can take what the enemy intended for evil, He could turn around for the good. There's no other God that can do that.
But boy, we have to sign up for the journey, don't we?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, we have to know Him and trust Him well enough.
That's it.
To know that He's going to be there, be who He says He is, do what He says He'll do.
Absolutely.
And in it is the victory.
That's it.
Yeah. We are skimming the surface of so much, folks. And I just want to tell you that this book is called Faith Forward Future, and it's all about all of that. And you don't want to miss it. It's available wherever books are sold. We're all going through difficulties in some area of our lives. How do you make that work for you? How do you bring Jesus into the middle of it and find your victory? We've also got a social exclusive interview with Chad on our Facebook page. If you'd like to watch that, just go to facebook.com/700cub. Faith Forward Future, it's available wherever books are sold. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Another wonderful message. We appreciate it so much.